And now, The Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Sorry for the late start, everybody. Bevelations on Radio Andy is on before us, and we had to clear out all the mm-hmms out of the room before we sat down. It is The Bonfire.
The Vagabonds of Sirius. No home to call our own. They moved us out of Studio 5.
We just got chumped by Bev, whatever, Bevelations.
Do you think we got chumped?
100%.
Yeah. You think we
100%.
Did?
Yeah, dude.
Because you were standing here. I was
I don't read that falsely. I'm not looking for trouble ever anywhere. That was fuck that shit. Her and her fucking goof crew fucking walked out of here. And her first word, as she doesn't even have her fucking ass out of the door yet, she goes, why? And we started, Lou started walking to the door, and she's like, oh, she goes, oh, you guys better get in there. We stopped the show early so you guys can get in there. I thought we have, it's like that kind of shit.
Yeah.
Fuck you, you fucking goofy twat.
Well, it's the just.
Fucking Lou thanked her.
Well.
He's got to live with that the rest of his night.
I assume she was being cool. Now that you say that.
You know what would have got your
mind
off?
I mean, sometimes you do. I mean, yeah, I wasn't there, so I can't say how it was said or whatever. Because sometimes you do look for that, like, kind of like, they disrespected us. But that sounds pretty like they were like, oh, you guys are fucking an inconvenience on us now.
Black Lou, support me.
I agree with you 100%.
Yeah, man. You agree with them 100%.
Yeah,
it was just kind of like that fucking, all right, well, we're supposed to get
there. There was no pleasantry.
You're walking out of the studio at 59.
Yeah.
What did you think we were going to, like, what
else
would
we do? Our show starts at 6.
So what are we going
to
do?
So, Jay, to answer your question, as someone that didn't hear it, was it kind of like this tone? Was it like, surprised you guys aren't in there. We had to get out of there fast, like that?
No, it was like, hey, guys, like basically telling us, like, oh, don't you have to move your asses? I mean, we have to end our show and get out of there.
Which is not their fault, but it is a problem that, it, you know, fucks
with
both
of
us.
It ain't our fault either. She didn't walk out, and we didn't go, hey, thanks for rushing for us.
By the way,
like,
they are.
That kind of shit. We didn't do that.
And the agreement is they're supposed to be out by 57, right, Jacob?
No, they're off at 57.
Which means they're done at 57.
Yeah, I mean, the show officially ends at 57, and I gotta give them.
Comedy Central just has to give us our own studio. Where Nikki and us should share a studio that they can do shows in between ours during the day. That way, we have a pre-record from 4 p.m. to 8 p.m., and Nikki has the studio from 8 to noon.
They can't invest like that, Nikki. What if she finds more stars to dance with?
Well, that Russian man was one hell of a dancer.
I know. I asked her, I was like, you wanted to fuck him, right? Of course, she had to want to.
Yeah, that guy's
body.
She said,
yes, of course.
Yeah.
She didn't, I don't think, but she was like, oh, yeah, she totally wanted to.
Yeah.
That guy was gorgeous.
Gorgeous. And just no,
and tossing her around and shit.
He has 0% body fat and can command you. No, now dance back. Now dance that way.
She did great. Nikki did. She did really great. I would seem like a nervous situation. But yeah, but.
A lot of the problems that we've had here at Sirius are because we don't have a studio to go through. We're the refugees of Sirius. So we're just causing a bunch of problems with whoever we bump into. But that sounds like it was something where it was like they were shitty to us. With something that's not our fault, and it's not their it's not our fault they have to leave, and it's not their fault that we don't have a studio.
Yeah, look, absolutely not their fault. I know. And look, full disclosure, I mean, for the sake of funny, and I do not like that they shuffle us around very thoughtlessly. However, this is a good studio.
Great studio.
It's a very good studio. I'm fine. You know, we come in, you need to take a couple minutes to clean the jizz and glitter off the seats, and you're good to go. But I mean, come on. That's fucking weak shit to have somebody walk and just like, oh, and Lou thanked her.
Mm. I assume she was being cool. I just thanked her and ran in.
He's so afraid of black people. Growing up that close to Teaneck, New Jersey, scared of black people.
Well, I never went into Teaneck. I'm just a block away.
he's always around.
You'd yell shit with your fucking Irish mixed friends outside the border of town.
If it's a green light.
I wish you would.
Because if it's a green light and I got my window down, I'm going to say something. I'm going to drive by. If it's a red light, I'm going to roll my window up and not say a thing and just turn up Pearl Jam.
It was sassy black passive aggressiveness.
Okay.
And I hated it.
Yeah, passive aggressiveness is my least favorite quality in anybody.
I would have thought different, even with the same words, if she laughed with us and kind of even gave, like, isn't this ridiculous what they're making us do, this turnover? Like, it wasn't. It was like, well, why don't you guys move your, you know, you need us out so bad, I guess.
My love, bud.
Oof. Is that her?
Yeah.
It's 2 hours of, I don't, are those words?
She's
what was
been
that?
On our show.
She's been on our show before.
Yeah. I know.
That's why I thought she was automatically cool. I don't have time to talk. Thank you. Bye, Bev.
No, first of all, she's Team Fugues the whole way. That's 110%.
You don't know that.
How could that?
You don't
I know do
that.
Know that. They were on a TV show together.
But that doesn't mean that they fucking like each other.
Oh, buddy, it does.
Well, also, he's not on the TV show anymore, so who's to say that they don't, what if we don't know that that's an ally?
No.
Against the Fugues.
It's not an ally.
Against Insight Radio.
Because she just treated us like fucking jerk-offs.
Yeah, so you think she hates us because
she disrespects. Oh, look at that match made in heaven right there.
Yeah,
mm-hmm. Fucking John Fugel sang Wally Collins. Girl, John Fugel sang girl Wally Collins.
Girl.
Yeah. Well,
right, honey,
I'm interested to see.
Bev-licious.
I'm interested to see how I'm going to be much more conscious or aware of the interaction tomorrow. Now,
I mean, I'm going to be blaring Patti LaBelle out of my phone and just go, and I'm going to point to my phone and her a bunch. Like, am I meeting for the first?
I would love if she signed something of yours. She's just so used to it. She signs it. She's like, who do you want me to make it out to?
Dude, I swear to you, I'm going to say something. When they walk out, I'm going to be like, guys, they mean 57 white people time. Mm-hmm. See if it's going to be an HR nightmare.
Well, that'll be fun because I guarantee they will not side with us. I guarantee you they'll not side with us.
We'll be back, Dan Soder, and special guest Big Joe. Side with
they will not side with us. Yeah, you're picking a fight. You're like picking a fight like this isn't gonna it's gonna go our way. Nothing goes our way. We don't have a fucking studio. They have their own studio.
Black Lou is our only. He's our piece of justice. He is now officially. What do you mean we have a black friend? Yeah.
They're going to be like, what channel are they on? Are they on white nationalist radio? Yeah.
Suck my dick, but Phillip, I'm saying Sirius XM.
You're talking like there's going to be any, even a shred of fairness. Like, they're going to be like, no, you guys, it's the Bonfire. They don't give a fuck.
How appalling is that? That's a white man's place in 2018, everybody.
That's Big J, officially the new Richard Spencer.
Nobody wants to hear our complaints at HR. They go, were you attacked? They ask me, were you attacked by another whiter person? And yeah, I'll go,
he was.
No, he was Puerto Rican. He goes, I'm not going to get involved in something like that.
The only way I can go is if he has doctorate, then we maybe have a case.
Maybe.
But I'm, that's not, you're taking it back to race. I'm talking about the fact that I'm saying Sirius doesn't care about us.
No.
That's why we're so movable.
No,
so
you're no saying to that, take it to.
But agree. You're saying it like we're going to say something and they're going to be like, so sorry, guys. They're going to be like, go fuck yourselves. We'll put you in a smaller studio.
I don't care about we'll cut you guys down to three. Anymore, but you're not going to fucking chump me when I walk.
Yeah.
When you walk out of the fucking studio.
Yeah.
I'll make you go talk to somebody in this building up top. Her and Fugue's going to be fucking holding hands in an office somewhere.
Yeah, we're going to be, Insight Radio is going to get us pushed off. They're going to get us completely pushed off.
Yeah, push our asses right to Patreon.
Yeah, right to a Patreon.
Comedy Central has our backs. I know they do. They don't like ethnics. They don't just put a bunch of things on Comedy Central. They'll never get. Please don't say that about us.
Yeah, there's a Viacom lawyer listening. Going,
Viacom doesn't want to hire women or blacks.
He goes, this son of a bitch almost torpedoed our stock.
That'd be great to find out. That's how we have to find out how much power we have. We have to say over the top obnoxious shit and see how much hate mail we get, and I'm sorry, we were just trying to get some numbers. Get any numbers.
Yeah, can I tell you how dumb I am? I tried to cover my cough up, and instead of hitting the cough button, I turned my headphones down, so I just coughed in the mic.
Oh, it's hilarious. You cranked it up?
Yeah, but I turned my ears down, and it just coughed into the mic.
Just the rest of us could hear it?
Yeah, I didn't know that.
Hey guys,
yeah,
how was that?
Let's see how powerful we are with Viacom.
We can see how much hate mail we get back. We just say awful things.
And then I'm back waiting tables, and I'm going, hey, Jay, that wasn't really good enough of a jump to take. I got to close lunch on Thursday.
I'm telling you, I'm right. Let's see how fast they walk out of the studio tomorrow.
Yeah.
And let's see. No one move.
Yeah.
When they leave, allow them their full time to leave. I'm telling you, her back foot wasn't out of this door before she was giving a shit like, well, why aren't you guys like right on top of jumping in the door behind us? I thought you need us out in time. And it's like, yes, well, if all your walks weren't saunters while saying a long name, Mary, what's going on?
Are you calling her Jack A?
I made her Jack A in the story. Why you ain't walking in the studio, Lewitsky?
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see, because this is what happens. We are the migrants.
I keep this up. They'll just kick us out of the studio. It won't matter. We'll get a new studio. Yeah. That's what we're being the guy in solitary confinement that keeps covering everything in shit.
Yeah, I think
we got to put him back in Gen Pop. We're running out of pads.
They go, we can't. We're just going to have to move him to a different place. Yeah. Then we're not even on Sirius anymore.
We're smearing verbal shit on our faces and walls.
Like, do we just put them in this cage? And they went fucking nuts.
This is inhumane!
They go, the elevator behavior was one thing, but now they're taking it inside the studio.
Can we do that? Can we all agree that we're not going to move? We'll let them leave, like, clear the studio out, and see if another thing is said?
I mean, yeah.
Is that fair?
Well, let's see what's... We know what's going to happen. Her producer, the...
No, not what's going to happen. I'm saying, see if they leave. First of all, one later than they said they would. And two, with like a...
No, I'm
a
saying back
and by the way, don't fucking tweet at the show.
They're going to hear about this.
Don't tweet at the show and say, it's like, this is... This is us talking about office problems. We don't want you to be like, fucking move.
Don't do that. People talk, so just assume what we're saying right now is automatically get back to Bev and then make your plan.
That's fair. No, I just said that. Let's see tomorrow. Maybe I'm just totally wrong.
I don't know. I wasn't looking in her eyes. I was too busy putting my head down and apologizing and running in.
Yeah, Lou just tucked it.
Dude, I get it, Lou. I'm of the same ilk.
I'm a nice guy. I'm a tuck and apologize and move forward.
I'm not a J. I'm not like a fucking let's get justice. I'm like, fuck, man, I'm sorry. Am I in your way? I probably did something. I don't know.
It's just me and Black Lou fighting for justice by ourselves.
Jacob's on board with his fingers on his temples.
Jacob looks like his body language is pretty good.
Jacob's like your campaign manager that's gonna
cost us a lot of votes in Ohio. That's a swing state. Jay, you can't just go up there and freewheel. You got taxes and job rent, job growth.
It would be funny to be yelled at in the hallways by someone who goes, did you call me Jack A on the radio? I'm like, yeah.
You go, Soder actually equivalated it with Jack A. Yeah. I said you elongated it during your song.
I did a Jack A impression. Yeah. Say that's how you were walking out of the studio.
He put the name Jack A to
it. For the younger listeners that don't know what 227 is.
Or designing women.
Ladybugs. That's the one you pull out for that, because that's what got Christina on Jack A was.
Yeah, Ladybugs with Dangerfield.
She does not get the reference of Mary, because that's too.
Wasn't Ladybugs just Joanna Man, but with children's soccer?
Yeah. They couldn't find a white kid named Joanna.
Yeah, they go.
Jonathan Brandis before he choke jerked.
He choke jerked. Sidekicks.
Look at the way he died. Jonathan Brandis.
Forget that. Hey, kid, you're going to dress up like a lady, and then we're going to run. They could have made that movie a dark, dark comedy.
Oh, yeah.
There's part of me that thinks that probably maybe it was, where he's like, yeah, Rodney's pitching it. Yeah, I'm going to have my kid's son. Oh, my girlfriend's son is going to play for girls soccer.
Not to go back, but I do want to stress to the people, please don't.
I said that.
Fucking, yeah. I know you said it, but reiterate. Don't tweet it or show. Don't ever. We'll fill you in on what goes on. If you force a situation, it's all going to be horseshit anyway, and then it's going to be unnecessary problems. But I'll tell you, I'll tell you tomorrow what happens when they walk out of the studio. Maybe I'm just being... I'm looking for trouble, Dan. You're right. I don't want to look for trouble.
Maybe we'll just be in the comedy office from here on out.
I stand by everything I said is wildly hilarious, but that I'll wait. We'll wait and see. Jacob, is that okay? Can we wait and see tomorrow? And then if she chumps your little bitch white ass again, then can we say something? She's going to pick you up and tit fuck you. She's going to tit fuck herself with your entire body.
I just, if possible,
oxy tonight.
I would like to just remain cool with her because, you know, she should be a friend of the show.
Of course.
You
know, listen, she came on the show. She was lovely.
You know, that's all.
I thought that was a weird thing. So maybe I'm jumping the gun.
Yeah, you do. I mean, as your friend, I will say, I didn't hear it, so I have no opinion on it.
Maybe I'm jumping the gun.
You might be jumping the gun.
Because here's, by the way, when they walked out, I didn't think anything of it. When they leave to me. I'm not going to give, because I understand they are probably told they have to cut a few minutes earlier so we can get in.
Well, how would we react to that?
Cut a few minutes so somebody can get in?
If we were told that we had to get out of 5,
I would talk shit all over the radio about it.
Yep.
And then when we left, I would leave.
Yeah.
And if we were late for any reason, first of all, if we were late, I'd be stressing that we are the ones fucking up. But I'd be saying, why do you have to make us cut our show short for another show? Hang on.
Okay.
Why do you have to make us cut our show short for another show? But when we walk out and those show people are waiting in the hallway, I'm not going to be like, all yours, dude. I get, you know, here we are, 3 minutes early. You know what I'm saying? I wouldn't have any kind of, how's the show's fault?
What are you going to say, Lou?
Let's check the last few minutes of her show and see if she mentioned it and complained about having to leave early.
Is that possible?
Get on it, B.L. Johnson!
Good idea.
Let's do our research. B.L. Johnson is a fucking cool name, though. Where did you bust that out of?
Sean Fury, dog.
No, he calls him L.J.
Oh, right. Oh, B.L.
B.L. B.L. Johnson? What a fucking cool name.
There's a B.L. from Ron and Fez days. B.L.
Anyways, back to Jonathan Brandis. He killed himself November 11th, 2003. He hung himself in the hallway of Los Angeles. I just lost where it was. In the hallway of his Los Angeles apartment building. Body was discovered and paramedics called. He died that afternoon.
Yeah.
From the angels. He did not leave a suicide note.
No. I thought he was going to die. I thought he was going to come.
I don't think you choke jerk in the hallway, though.
Why not? What if that's where the best knowledge
is? In the hallway of his. Oh, I thought it was in the hallway of the building. I was like, you know.
Oh, like in front of apartment 2B?
Yeah, you're like, oh my God, the guy from 2C is hanging in between 2A and 2B. Just, What? You think you're onto something?
I got B.L. Johnson on the case.
Black Lou, if we were private talking about reporter.
Okay.
He's going to go talk to her a producer and see what's
happening. I hope, for the record, it's all peace.
What's that, Jacob?
Allison.
Yeah, I know.
Jacob needs this job.
This is the difference in, like, yeah, I'm more Lou than I am Jay in this situation, where I'm just kind of like, all right, I would have just apologized and walked in and not taken it, you know?
But if my hunch is right, yeah, then Lou feels silly about that.
Yes. Oh, absolutely. Then you feel embarrassed because you're like, oh, you let him. No, absolutely. And that's where my 0-60 comes in. Then I'm mad at myself, which I then, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Let it outward when you realize that.
Maybe I'm just a little jealous too. I do feel like when we have interacted with Bev,
mm-hmm,
that she's way on Team Dan.
Well, she's very dismissive. She knows me from Billions.
Right.
So she doesn't know you.
Yeah.
She knows me as being on a TV show she watches. So
she knows you as Mafi. She doesn't know you, Dan Soder,
at all. Because she always, whenever she sees me, she's like, Mafi! And you're like, hi.
You know? She treats you like white businessmen in Times Square.
Yeah. Or I'm like, hello, diversify, sell, buy.
She calls you Mafi?
The two times I've seen her.
That's pretty hilarious. So she shows you a lot of love. And she was a little like.
And I went on her show.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. She talks to you like someone she sees. She looks right past me, I think. So maybe I'm just upset because I love her.
Yeah.
I want her to love me, too.
We got to the root of it.
Maybe it's what it is. I'm starting therapy on Friday, Dan. I love you. Maybe this is all therapy stuff.
Hey, everyone in this room loves you.
Mm-hmm.
Look around.
Mm-hmm.
You're loved.
No.
By me, a man in a Mets hat.
No.
Fuck yeah.
There's like one person who loves me, and I was showed that today. Black Lou. He got my back 110%. We went to war.
Do you see what
now.
You're doing?
I got your back.
Do you see what you're doing?
You're giving
reasons to not take the love.
We went to war.
And you're pushing us away. Christine, loving, caring girlfriend.
Turn on me on a dime.
Sits to your right.
On a dime, she would turn on me.
For Bev? Absolutely.
For Bev, in a heartbeat.
Yeah, oh, I mean, all of us. This whole room,
she'll low bridge me if she can get even an associate producer's credit on that show.
She'll take quotes from our shows out of context and play it to Bev to make us sound like hateful animals.
These guys are not good people. These guys are really racist.
She goes, can I tell you this? I've slept with this guy out of pure fear. Have you ever seen the movie Sleeping with the Enemy? She goes, that's Jay and I's relationship.
That's our relationship.
But I think you're pushing. When you should be pulling.
Yeah?
Pull them in tighter, dude.
Is that the idea?
I think it is.
Okay. Well, we'll see what tomorrow brings. I think that's fair.
She just comes out and jacks you in the throat.
Totally.
Yeah. She's like, you fucking wins. And stupid motherfucker.
You're beautiful like, fashion.
Oh, my God. Bev just fucking torqued her hips into that one and dropped Jay.
Just straightens me out.
You do that thing where you can't breathe. Is Shafir coming up? What's going on?
Maybe at the end of the day, I was completely wrong. But yeah,
we'll find out tomorrow.
I don't think I was completely wrong.
You are a goddamn good judge of situations.
Yeah, yeah, you are. I mean, you can break down things fast. So maybe you are right. And maybe she's like, maybe she comes on tomorrow. She's just like, fuck you. I don't want to get out of my studio early
because
of
you humps. Or maybe she comes down and she goes, hey, guys, I was a little like.
That absolutely could happen.
And by the way, you do that, I'll never bring it up again.
But see, this is why the internet fucks
shit
back,
up. Now you're back in the game.
Because this is a work thing that everyone deals with. Everyone deals with this as a work thing. But the difference is with the internet and our shit, is also we're broadcasting. But people can just go be like, hey, fuck you, get out of the studio. It's like, that's not what we're saying at all.
Now leave her alone. And by all means, I mean, most importantly, and there's no wink-wink to this, don't type fucking heinous shit to anybody on our behalf, ever.
Yeah, I've been recommending,
shitty stuff
I've been saying at live shows,
it sucks to see
I've been
that
recommending
yourself.
That everyone do too many mushrooms once in their lives.
Yeah.
Because I really think that stops you from talking shit on Twitter.
Well, really?
Just if you do too many mushrooms, you're like, that fear where you're like.
No, but I just have a thing where it's like, I don't, like, if she hears this show or whatever, and by chance or whatever, fine.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I didn't say anything that's not either, I believe, funny or true or what I think. But like people going and just writing awful shit. Like I hate seeing that when people do that. You don't even know where the source of it is. You're like, what the fuck is this?
Yeah.
And it's just like, it sucks. So I don't want that. I'd rather, I'm telling you as a fan of the show, if you're listening, enjoy the story. Tell you what happens. Like, we're going to come on tomorrow. Isn't that fun more to find out what happens?
Well, I think
instead
the internet,
of forcing into the hand of it to happen?
The internet makes people feel like they have more of an ability to change the story and interact.
Well, also, they'll put us in a position where we're going to be forced to keep our jobs or apologize.
Yeah.
I've been working here, guys, for 10 years.
Never had to apologize.
Never had to apologize.
But you know what I'm saying, though? Like, why put me in a position to have to, like, apologize? You know, I mean, like, who gives a shit? It's just funny radio stuff. But yeah, that's the worst. Social media. Brutal.
I'm almost
and also
off.
Lovely sometimes when you interact with people that are, I've met a lot of fans and friends through that.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But that's the people use it for good.
not for bad.
There's people who use it for evil. All right, should we find out? We'll take a break here in a few minutes, but like, is Ari coming? Or is
he said he fell asleep and he's heading up now.
Really hilarious. What a great Ari situation.
He's like, yeah, I'll come on the show. And he's like, oh, fuck, I woke up.
6:22, I fell asleep. I'm coming up now.
Fuck yeah.
Oh, yeah, I guess that happened. 6:22.
Isn't he going to leave early, too?
Maybe not now.
Dude, this is the word. I mean, when you're friends with stoners, I mean, it's Sober October. He should be in tip-top shape.
Yeah.
We're still detoxing.
Wasn't your friend Emily supposed to come up?
She's here. I got to grab her. I was waiting for break.
You guys.
Say something passive-aggressive when you walk out of the studio.
Please, when you walk out, I guess I'm doing a show.
Maybe that's how they leave. That's like
no matter what, you leave, you're passive-aggressive. Maybe it was not their fault at all.
At all. This is just, that's just the code of the studio.
Yeah.
We'll figure it out.
Yeah. But until then, it's the bonfire.
We're gonna drop kick them like Shaggy Two Dope.
Yeah, it's good weave. We're gonna get into that when we come back.
I'm excited to see Florence and the Machine. I don't care what Jay says.
What?
I don't care what you say. I'm excited to see him tonight.
You didn't hear what I said? I said, T-Rex, get up here, damn ship, T-Rex.
That's a good song.
Yeah, I hope she plays it 5 times. It's the only one I know.
Hey.
Is this Florence and the Machine?
Yeah.
Aww. This is a song that Lou's gonna cry to tonight alone on Bumble.
I always cry to it
alone on Bumble. Do you cry to this one? Is this a tear one?
Oh, I go jogging to this.
Hell yeah.
That's a lie.
Well, not till the end of the song and only for 1 minute.
Just 1 minute jogging intervals?
Because when I run to the car in the rain.
Climax.
Oh, that's mailbox and back run?
Oh. All right. That's good. I'm going. I'm going to enjoy it. I'm not going to, like, you know, I'm going to sit there with a frown on my face. Stupid song. I guess that one was okay. I'm going to enjoy the show. I just don't know.
I don't like a machine.
It's, yeah, we talk about going to Cypress Hill. With the exception of, like, 4 or 5 songs, maybe.
Yeah.
You'll know every fucking thing.
Yeah.
And that every song played.
Yeah.
You'll know it. And this is a concert where I'm going to know 3, maybe. Yeah. Maybe.
I'm going to know a lot.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You're a real flow head.
I'm a flow machi. Flow machi.
You're a flow mosh?
Flow mosh.
We'll be right back, everyone. It's a bonfire. In many bedrooms, I think we all know bedtime can be complicated. Am I on?
Yes, sir.
Just now. Did I get that first line out?
Yes, plus the cough.
Ooh. All right. Edit. In many bedrooms, bedtime is complicated, especially as the weather begins to cool, which it's starting to do now, yeah. Dan. I had a good
chill.
Open window sleep last night. Enjoyed it. But, you know, when one person sleeps soundly, the other one could either be freezing or way too hot. Well, Boll & Branch, the makers of the world's most comfortable sheets, loved by 3 U.S. presidents, are offering their luxury flannel bedding for a limited time at BollAndBranch.com. They're unbelievably soft, warm, and breathable. And I'm telling you, as flannel sheets go, that's very important.
Yeah.
Because it'll keep Christine warm when I don't want to be, but they're it's nice. It's such a nice feeling. You're using yours now. You're not using the flannel ones.
Not
the
flannel,
you're using the regular ones, but it's great. They come in 14 stunning patterns and colors. You're guaranteed to find a style that you love. Plus, you could try them, this is my favorite part, 30 nights risk-free. A 30-day complete trial. You can use the sheets, sleep on them, see if you enjoy them. If not, you give them back for a refund. But whatever you do, don't wait, because last year their flannel sheets sold out in just a few weeks. So if you go to BollAndBranch.com today for $50 off your first set of sheets plus free shipping, you have to use promo code BONFIRE. That's $50 off plus free shipping right now at BollAndBranch.com. Promo code BONFIRE, BollAndBranch.com, spelled B-O-L-L and branch.com. And the promo code, do you remember?
Bonfire?
Yes.
Nailed it.
And now, back to the bonfire with Big Jay Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Been on right after the first breakdown. It's the one song Jay knows. The one song that Jay likes of Florence and the Machine, and it's actually a Calvin Harris song.
She won't do it.
Nope. So it's the bonfire. Comedy Central Radio.
We'll do it with a fucking acoustic guitar or some bullshit.
Yeah. It's going to be some mysticism, which, as I said when we saw her at Bonnaroo in 2015, mysticism don't work that well in the afternoon.
It's not going to work good tonight either.
With a broken foot.
Nobody wants to hear mysticism from some freckle chest.
We all want to hear it, Jay.
Yeah, you're the only one that doesn't. It's the bonfire. Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Dan Soder. That sad sack of anger is Big J. Jay right now. He's angry.
I got belly full of tuna and I'm raging.
You know what would made this whole situation easier? The whole entire day and all of it? A giant rabbit in the studio.
A giant rabbit would've been nice.
Adorable rabbit.
It wouldn't have made things worse. Although I don't know if the show that's in here before us would like to have that thing, a big old rat.
I go, you do not talk about freckles that way. I come in and just pet his big old ear.
Look at that guy.
That crazy white boy with that big ass rabbit.
With that white trash shit. That's some white trash shit, having a big
ass
rabbit.
White trash shit. What's up, Peckerwood? What you got, yourself, big ass rabbit?
I go, I like him and he has a distinct personality.
He is my friend and my pet.
I love him.
Can we do all of our voices, even our own stereotypical, please?
I love him.
Daniel, I enjoy doing radio programs with you.
I like my giant rabbit, Bev.
After this, we will go to the supermarket grocery store.
Radio Andy, I enjoy my bunny rabbit.
I would be buying some 2% yogurt.
Something that I thought we were going to talk about yesterday, which I'm surprised we didn't get to, was one of the members of Insane Clown Posse.
Yeah, he really, he's a bad fighter, but he's a great wrestler. What he did was pure wrestling in execution.
Yes.
I don't think it was the thing, but Shaggy 2 Dope, the skinny guy from Insane Clown Posse, while Fred Durst was on stage in the Rock Allegiance, I think it's called, tour. Rock Allegiance tour. Limp Bizkit was playing. Limp Bizkit, by the way, I'll say it 100 times over. On Shiprocked, it was great.
They love it.
I even wanted to kind of be like, eh, Limp Bizkit. But I wasn't even like that going into it.
I
was like, I guess I'm supposed to hate this more, but I'm like, I'll see Limp Bizkit. I never saw him before.
Can I ask you a question of another band that might, like, if you saw maybe like a Third Eye Blind or like Sugar Ray. Let's say you were on a boat and you're like, nah, I'm going to go see Sugar Ray. And then they put on a hell of a performance. Would you walk away the same being like,
Never know, because I would try gay sex for the first time before I went to a Sugar Ray concert.
Really? If a man was like, suck my dick in the basement of
It's the same difference. Why am I beating around the bush? If I'm going to go to a Sugar Ray concert, I might as well just have sex with a man.
Oh, man.
I'll be the top.
Do you think that the music makes gay sex easier?
Oh, dude, don't you feel it? Listen to this. Is your butthole just like...
relaxing.
It feels like it goes...
Everything's relaxing.
Dude, if I was the wrinkles around your butthole right now are all completely smooth.
If I was getting kissed on the neck... are you inside me already?
And,
I don't know.
And we're in. As you go, Dan, it's like riding a bike. You go. All right, Jay. I think I'm ready for you to put it in. It goes. Yeah. It's been in for 5 minutes, man.
And I go.
What?
And then I just go. Wee!
Yeah. I go. Hey, champ. What if I told you it's been in for the past 5 minutes?
I go.
What?
Why don't you ghost ride this butt? Why don't you fucking jump off and run alongside it for a little bit, and then jump back on?
Ghost ride my boot.
Jump off it down a hill, then run next to it, then jump back on it.
Did you stop? I don't know. Did I? Or did I always have the sandwich? Pow! Right back in.
And then I went,
no, okay. Put the song back on from the beginning, because I tell you what, I was not loose on that one.
Sugar Ray is gay sex lube. Music gay sex lube is fucking awesome.
If there's any natural lubrication, as some would say, to anal, that's what makes that juices flow.
Yeah.
Sugar Ray music makes your asshole gush.
Now let's... Oh, so this is the video of Shaggy 2 Dope from ICP trying
So I'll say, Linkin Park, I don't know, in a festival like this, if Insane Cloud, do they perform ICP? Because if they perform like this, I think they do okay at a festival like this. I don't think it's dominating their fans there.
You're saying...
However, I mean, Gathering the Juggalos is insane. It's 100,000 people, and it's all for them.
From DeRosa's joke, I've never been, but just from DeRosa's joke...
Family.
Yeah, family.
But they're... I've done the festival a couple times.
If you walked up to a Burger King and heard that...
I love that joke that Joe had on his...
But, but if they... at a festival like this with all those bands, like ICP has some people there, I'm sure, that like them a lot, and some people that like them sort of casually.
Yeah.
But it's not their thing. Limp Bizkit, the way they perform, they have hits.
Yes.
So in a situation like this, if you're going to do something aggressive to Limp Bizkit, understand they're probably killing. They're probably killing.
What do you mean if you're doing something aggressive?
If Limp Bizkit, when I heard this story, I just assumed Gathering of the Juggalos happened, Limp Bizkit performed, and there was some thing backstage that was a problem, and Shaggy 2 Dope tried to kick him off. That makes sense to me. If he does that, it's major news. He'll get in trouble still. but it's major news, and like everyone there is also like, yeah, fuck Limp Bizkit. They'll just turn. If he goes, we don't like this guy now.
Yeah.
They just turn.
Yeah.
On a dime.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like that, it's over. So in this situation, though, it's not. So it's very weird. I wonder we still found out what the gripe was. I tried to hold the story a couple days.
So this is actually between Shaggy 2 Dope and Fred Durst of Limp Bizkit.
Yeah.
That's what this is for.
Fred Durst is wrapping up a song.
Okay.
And crowd seems totally into it.
Yeah.
And at the end of his song, what happens is Shaggy 2 Dope runs behind him.
Yeah, I love this. I do love the studio. Can I just say?
It's a good studio. Too bad we're not welcome in it.
I know.
When Shaggy 2 Dope runs out at the end of the song and does an actual wrestling style, professional wrestling style.
Yeah, hit him with the drop.
Double leg drop kick.
Double leg drop kick.
Much like wrestling.
Action Bronson hit him with the Marty Jannetty.
Much like wrestling. Dan, cover yours for a second.
Yeah.
He makes minimal contact, and it's just a slight little push tap that
what
barely moves Fred Durst.
What are you talking about?
Why were you listening?
Jimmy Superfly Snuka could execute it. It would knock
but
a man out.
I told
out.
You not to listen to that,
It would
Dan.
Knock a man out. Why don't you just tombstone me to death?
Dan, the tombstone is... They protect your neck within the guy's thighs.
Oh,
sorry, you don't have to hear that.
What
you
the
don't have to listen.
Fuck?
Don't listen to
what
it.
What the
don't even
actual
listen to me.
Fuck?
Don't even listen to me.
I think Fred Durst is about to get 2 feet of justice.
So the minimal amount Fred Durst moves with this tap that he almost casually turns around and go like, what was it? Just like, I guess my guitarist bumped into me for a second.
But by the way, you can do a drop kick that is powerful. If you fucking ran and fucking jumped.
All right, then. Fine.
I'm saying if you jumped into
also a scorpion
person,
deathlock has been known to cause death in some countries.
Dude, I'll fucking rip your goddamn knee tendon with a figure four right now.
Also,
you want to go? You want me to show?
Flying elbow is the most devastating.
You think your back hurts now? I'm going to put you in the walls of Jericho. We'll see how fucking much your back hurts.
The walls down!
Ah! Shout out to Chris Jericho, one of the greatest of all
yeah.
time.
Hell yeah. Mark McGrath does an XM show, so I guess Big J's for everyone at work now.
Yeah. Big J, it's Big J versus the world.
Shit. I forget there's microphones on, and there really is a moment of almost every day where I go, if I met Mark McGrath, probably like, hey, well, Mark McGrath, that's cool. Yeah. And like, I have a history of being like, hey, Fruit, you have music that loosens guys' buttholes to try gay sex for the first time.
Yeah, or you would rather have gay sex than go see them live, which is how that whole thing started.
Yeah, you're a Jewish summer camp fucking dream come true.
Yeah.
First time you're going to try some gay
Ooh.
Stuff.
So let's watch the video of Shaggy 2 Dope drop kicking Fred Durst. He's on the edge of the stage. He looks like he's doing well. Everyone's got their hands up, and that does not work. And by the way, security.
Here's the bet. My favorite angle is this, because he's just jamming.
Miss.
It's a slight shove.
And that is one of the members of ICP. He's not in his makeup.
Shaggy 2 Dope.
Calm down. It's one guy. What's two guys?
And Wes Borland's all covered in paint. He has to wash his face off after every
Dude,
performance.
That's what I love about Halloween night, the end of the night when you have to watch it. That and Comic-Con, when everyone's got to be serious, tired, crying, sad, angry, or whatever, walking home dressed like a fucking caveman or something.
I mean,
so
Fred
funny.
Durst does dress like I would if I didn't give a fuck.
I'll tell you what, Fred Durst...
If I didn't give a fuck, I would wear receiver's gloves under a long-sleeve white shirt with a Bo Jackson jersey over it and camo pants and a hunting hat.
Fred Durst stayed pretty cool, dude.
That Fisher hat with the beard is just like his look now.
he
went beard.
Pretty cool.
He threw a beard
when
on
When he
it.
Performed on Shiprock, dude, I was impressed with how like just he just does his songs. I think he even knows they're semi-dated, but they're like, it just, and everyone was way in.
Now my question to you is, do you know what happened between Shaggy 2 Dope and Fred Durst? Do they report on it? Or
That's what I want to find out. All the information I got beyond this was DJ Lethal.
Yeah.
From Limp Bizkit.
Yeah.
Started tweeting a bunch of them, and the funniest tweet to me that... The big question mark for me was when he goes, this fucking sucks, man. He goes, was a huge fan till today. He goes, you were?
Yeah, you were.
It's weird. He goes, DJ Lethal's a big ICP fan. It's
big ICP
weird to me
fan?
For some reason.
Yeah, just listening to him. Is there a follow-up on it at all? Or what happened?
There's got to be a search in the world for the most successful juggalo. Like, real confirmed juggalo. There's got to be a story
like
on that.
Barry Levowitz.
They've done the story of all the meth addict ones.
Pediatrician in, like, Maine. And he's like, I just unwind with some ICP.
Yeah.
Because I love it. I got a hatchet man on my arm. I cover it up during surgery.
Dude's fucking. Did we anything more? Do you have DJ, you have DJ Lethal's tweets though, right?
Yeah, that's right here.
This is his Instagram.
Yeah. Sorry, Instagram. Yeah.
Want to hate? Haters want to hate. God, I hate when people start anything with that sentence. Because it really is just—it's just such a fucking douchebag way to start a sentence.
Well, Dan,
haters gonna hate.
But he has not always starts a sentence. If he wants to double down on his douchebaggery,
yeah,
he starts the sentence with "ha ha ha." Haters want to hate, but can't take the heat. Full new sentence,
bro. Step up. Is this lyrics to a fucking? Are these lyrics to a song? What haters want to hate, but can't take the heat.
No, man to man. No sucker stage rushing. I'm gonna get on TMZ. You and your 8 foot 500 pound goon got squashed.
Hashtag Booyah.
Booyah Tribe.
Booyah Tribe. Hashtag DJ Lethal. For your right, you got to fight for your right to party. This bum fail, bro. Ha 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 ha. Hashtag choked out. Hashtag step to me. Hashtag Mr. TMZ tough guy.
Hashtag bro fail.
Most desperate fail of all time. And the thing, dude, it really, social media just fucking ruins everybody. You just see how people think and you're like, oh, dude, god damn it, you're a douchebag too.
This is talking, saying things as a DJ Lethal's got to be 50.
50.
He wrote, you bitch made G fuck you. Just a weird. All right.
The latest thing, it's just speculation on why it happened. It says they've had beef since, you know, Woodstock. So it's been two decades.
The 90s. Yeah. Hold on to that, huh?
Yeah. Fucking. They're like, I'm holding on to this shit since the Lewinsky scandal. I will fucking dropkick you in 2018 with your back turned.
How could you even bring up a gripe with something you had in
20 years ago?
20 years ago.
19 years ago?
You're all adults.
Well, here's.
I can understand it.
It's honest to God. It's honest to God. It'd be like Hulk Hogan, like seeing like Randy Savage, like today, and being like, you know, he goes, "Hey, what was that? You called me at the Garden, but now you want to fucking be friends and go to dinner together."
Dude, did you guys hear what happened at that autograph signing? Hulk Hogan punched Sergeant Slaughter right in the mouth. Said, "You burned my face."
Yeah,
that was like, from SummerSlam '93.
Pearl Jam. You ever see Pearl Jam
live? Well, it started 20 years ago when ICP was trying to. This is what the caption is on where the Limp Bizkit and ICP beef that you were so desperately worried about. This is where it started. Well, it all started 20 years ago when ICP was trying their hardest to sell out. They performed at Woodstock, and after was told Fred wants to meet with you, and they had no idea who the fuck Fred was. I guess Fred Durst was a mega superstar and egoed out on them hard, like wouldn't look at them or anything while he talked. He invited them on Family Values Tour with Korn and all those bands, then at the last minute told them to fuck off outside and booted them. They were on this huge festival show Monster sponsored together, and I'm assuming he was a cunt again. So that was...
He's holding the grudge. That's a pretty good fuck you.
Yeah.
Like, told him to join the Family Values Tour and then went, fuck off.
Yeah, just fuck off. Just big dog him.
That's weird.
Yeah, oh, look who decided to show.
Well.
Let's hit him with the passive aggressiveness that we all get hit when we walk in the door.
No, that's cool, dude. The show's been on for the
right amount of time. I'm glad you're here. Thanks for taking your time getting here, Ari.
I was sleeping.
Yeah, I know you were sleeping. Christine Toretta's the fucking text message. On the show, you know him. You love him. Ari Shaffir.
Yeah.
A sober October, Shaffir. How you feeling?
I feel like a fucking... Oh, can I curse on this? Are we on FM? I feel like Joe List after a wedding.
You just want to go dance?
I'm just bored.
Yeah?
I've never actually passed bars before by myself. Thinking like I want to go in there.
Yeah,
but you know what's funny? I didn't know that. I never think that Sober October is coming up for you guys, and that you do that thing every year. So now it does make sense that twice in the month before this, I got things from Mario like, "Hey man, want to just go have some drinks in the neighborhood?"
He was like, saying that when I talked to him right when he was like, "Yeah, I was telling Jay we gotta start having more beers."
That wasn't in expectation of this. That was just because I was come from Edinburgh where I got drunk or. You know,
go for drinks. It's kind of what people do. Go to pubs and stuff.
Let's fucking get some drinks in the East Village. It's nice out. And then October hit. I'm like, motherfucker.
Yeah, it's funny. It's not a bad idea at all. I'm just saying, it was very, like, two times close together out of, like,
That's one
first
of the things,
times ever.
That's one of the things I'm
close to. It's like, let's do some stuff in this.
Yeah, that's one of the things I'm most jealous of. People that can just go out and have two beers and then be like, cool, let's go home now. Because I'll be like, let's have two beers. Let's have a shot.
Anybody got a rubber band I can tie off real quick?
I'm like, let's fucking get it. Let's get it. Yeah. Em's just sitting back.
She's stat boy. She's correcting all our mistakes.
Yeah, she's Tony Reale of the fucking Bonfire. She's
gonna what did we get wrong?
She goes, Bev was actually a fan of yours. That was a wrong. We were just talking about ICP and Limp Bizkit beef. So,
oh, there's a beef there.
Well, they tried to play it for Ari real quick, if you can, Christine. If you want, look, how do we do this?
Is that like they're gonna have like a garbage cup to see who's the lamest of all?
Yeah, watch them try to drop kick him.
Now, which one is this?
That's Fred Durst, and then here comes the guy from ICP. Boom, mists.
Yeah. Give him the side view. The side view is actually more fair.
Yeah, here it is, right here. So watch him come out, and you're gonna watch him run out. Wet miss.
And security did a terrible job.
I mean, security's on him pretty fast,
but not after the head kick that he meant to throw at him.
Yeah.
By the way, go back to the beginning of this angle again. What the fuck is DJ Lethal doing in the back?
Oh.
Someone really, man, the real crime's happening back there. What was that weird movement?
He tried to kick Fred Durst in the head.
He looks like DJ Lou.
And, yeah, I love that DJ Lethal, we were just reading his Instagram post, and that's the guy who wrote like that.
You're a bitch made G.
He's like, you a bitch made G. And you look him there, and he's like, honey. He looks like he has six daughters.
Honey.
And he's just like, guys, get in the house. We got to take Hannah to soccer practice.
I like Fred Durst's whole thing.
Yeah. I'll tell you this. I said.
Wearing a beast mode shirt?
He's wearing a fucking, no, that's a
Under Armour, Bo Jackson jersey.
Yeah, he's
some
in.
Fucking Zubaz.
Are they beating him up? They
working
beat him
it.
Up.
Yeah, they're definitely roughing him up, and then he's like, get off him.
Where's two guys?
It's just fucking white boy pushing.
Yeah.
He didn't even stop playing.
Dude, now I'm so fascinated to know how much Wes Borland regrets painting himself back in the 90s and just being that thing is, that's your career.
Why is he wearing
gloves? By the way, you really know that you can't stop. I mean, Fred Durst stopped wearing the red hat thing.
Well, Wes Borland stopped painting himself for a little bit when he left Limp Bizkit.
When he started his own stuff. No, I think he always did everything he did. He's always been.
Really?
If we wore face paint.
Yeah. I heard he did all of that for the Nookie.
Come on.
Here's a weird thing. And I don't want to just break stuff.
That's funny. He did it all for the Nookie. Come on.
What?
The Nookie. Come on.
Come on. The Nookie.
Come on.
Hey, while you're at it, take this cookie and stick it in your yeah.
What?
Stick it in your yeah.
Dumb.
That was dumb.
It's going to be fun to see when that music becomes like disco for us. Remember when we were growing up, we're like, fucking disco. You're like, look how dumb this is.
Yeah, but disco was like a very defined amount of time.
So was that?
What?
Like Limp Bizkit? I mean,
rap metal?
Rap metal was really
late
90s.
No, that's the seeds of things that are now, totally. I think that's the...
Well, couldn't you say disco was the seed of some music forms?
Yeah, but disco was like across the board. Like everybody listened to it. This was like... A small group for about 2 years.
No, huge group for several
fat,
years.
Fat, you mean?
Fat people.
Fat people for several years.
A huge group of huge people.
A lot of black t-shirts.
But the evolution of that music is still very, like... Again, it comes to... Yeah, Beastie Boys is the start of that, yeah. Because they were a punk band that did rap, too. So the evolution... I don't know who exactly it would be like today, but it's all the Linkin Park. It was all the same
Look
stuff.
Look at that.
Yeah, Woodstock.
Damn.
That is a lot of motherfuckers.
Motherfuckers in the pit! Motherfuckers in the pit! All you people on the side!
Who's all painted up?
Wes Borland?
Wes Borland, yeah.
Who is that? Just his guitarist?
Yeah.
Where else did he play?
I don't know, but this is like... Motherfuckers in the pit! This was the riot, right?
He's a good front man.
Get up, you get the fuck up.
Oh, I thought this was me at Goddamn Comedy Jam.
It was.
That's actually Fred Durst. Sorry.
This is, yeah. This is, God damn it. What's the Comedy Central Festival that we did?
Clusterfest.
That's where I did this. Right?
I know.
Damn, that's the best white boy music. Just jump.
Yeah. Yeah,
it's
yeah
the
no
best
rhythm.
Way to dance.
No rhythm.
Anybody
no side
can,
to side.
Everybody can get involved.
Up, down, up. Down, up, push, up, down.
Do you think there's some nerds? Down. Do you think there's some nerds in that pick? Like, I don't know if I can do it. I don't want to
jump on time. Jump on time. Jump on time. Yeah, it was. Hold on. What were you saying, Jacob?
He says same drummer, but I didn't see the drummer. You're talking about the DJ, DJ Lethal? Those being weird behind him? Is he huge now?
That kid.
Yeah, that's why I was...
I didn't see the drummer on the new
video. Joe C. Look, Joe C's in the background.
That's Joe C. Oh, I thought that was a real kid.
No, that was Joe C from Kid Rock.
Oh, he was
no
real, Ari. He's just a little person.
God, Ari, little people are real people.
Disagree. I mean, if we're talking about rights, I'm disagreeing with you guys. If we're talking about, like, actual life, yeah, technically.
I identify as Wes Borland. I'm going to start painting my face like that.
Are you
creeping you guys out?
No way, there's no way you wouldn't get in the energy of this.
Oh, for sure I would. I can jump over here.
Em, why are you holding your bag like we're going to steal it? We're not going to steal your bag. Em's sitting like she's on a bus with a bunch of shady people. She's like, okay, one of these fuckers is going to go for this bag.
Do you want a Black Lou to show you his ID or something? So you know he's legit people? Yeah. He's got a work badge.
Everybody in the back! You guys start doing that on live bonfires?
Everybody over there to the right! Everybody in the back of the Village Underground! If you're ready to hear noises now, and we gotta talk like Fred Durst.
I'm gonna do all my drive-thru orders like Fred Durst.
Shit.
I wanna get a Whopper. Whopper with cheese to all the people on the grill. Then I want you to go back and hold the lettuce.
And then I gotta let it go. And then I want some onion rings.
I want the people to give me a shake.
Fucking that way of talking.
Throw in an extra burger and wrap that shit up. Get an original chicken sandwich, no fries.
Are you guys getting ready for Florence and the Machine by Limp Bizkit?
I am. This is what'll be playing in my head.
Jay's going to Florence and the Machine in a dirty diaper.
Dude, if she plays a cover, if she plays an LP cover.
I love to play this. Sometimes you feel like you just want to break stuff. But we're in this in together.
She does a mashup of
Where are we sitting? I'll start a mosh pit. Florence and the Machine.
Dude, you spill so much white wine.
Hell yeah.
What do we got? My Chablis.
My Chablis. I don't know. Did you look up the seats, Christine?
We got floor or seats?
Are they garbage? I don't know. We're in the pit. Get in the pit.
Just the people in the front now.
She goes,
all the people to the side now. All the people to the left now. Everybody get in the goddamn pit. If you strong stays over. If you clear the middle.
Just fucking jam.
There's a giant pentagram I made on the floor earlier in yak blood. Oh, if you fear the love of Satan coursing through your veins, get in the motherfucking pit. I am pregnant by the Dark Lord himself. My goat child will reign 1,000 years of evil on this planet.
There are the people in the back say, yeah.
A lovely friend of mine, Mr. Frederick Durst.
Frederick.
Hey, Flo.
Did you figure? Oh, you're looking it up now. Yeah. Yeah, I'm excited. I like Florence and the Machine.
I don't know them well enough. I guess.
We are right here.
Where are we?
I know some older stuff.
Yeah,
really good seats.
Section 24.
Yep. Yeah. It's fantastic.
Wait. So those are chairs, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Seats. Fantastic seats.
Those are fantastic seats.
Nobody can block you.
Watch. Dude, I got fake tickets to the Yankee game.
You will see perfect.
You did?
Yeah.
Yeah. Really?
Yeah. But as soon as Edberg pointed it out, he's like, "Those are." I just told him, I was like, you got robbed, man. I was like, what?
How did you do? What happened?
The guy was like, I'm selling four tickets, two each, whatever.
You said to blow him and all his friends?
Yeah. And he goes, also, I got to film it real quick. Don't worry, you can wear a mask, like one of those soiree parties.
But you swear they're real, though?
Yeah, he goes, these are good tickets? He goes, dude, Reggie Jackson gave them to myself. He's pulling his dick out.
He goes, and they're looking at each other while Ari's sucking. He goes, I told this guy Reggie Jackson gave me.
He goes, did it. Because Mr. October, like I know Mr. October.
Who the fuck am I?
So
I wrote these tickets in pen.
Because it's on a piece of paper.
I made a lot of mistakes. I had to cross some shit out.
It's a Burger King bag.
They're legit, right, guy?
He just drew lines to make a barcode.
And he goes, dude,
thick one, thin one, thinner.
He puts it up to his phone. Bloop, see? They're good.
Yeah. He makes the noise.
He goes,
green. Says they're good, too. Says they're good seats.
Got a green pointer and point it at the ticket.
It's just a green laser pointer. He goes, bloop, see? And you go, all right, that's good for me. I'll suck it. Pull that dick out.
Guess I'm sucking you and all your friends' dicks.
So 200 each?
200 each. And I went lofty and I was like, I'll get four. I'll bite people.
You're a good man.
Wait, was this not the same one you went to with Feeney and those guys?
No, this was yesterday.
Oh, okay, yesterday.
16-1 blowout. I'm a Sox fan now.
Shelled anyway,
I'm a Sox
right?
fan now. I changed it up.
Yeah. You flipped?
You do that. Yeah, you were a Ryan O'Neal fan. Now you're a Lucia Gomez
fan. I was only in the Ryan O'Neal fight to motivate Lewis.
I heard you just wanted to move the line.
Yeah.
He just wanted to move the gambling line. Ari's always sports booking it.
It's all about the needle.
Yeah, move that fucking
percentages,
needle.
Bro.
We have a guy, Randy from D.C., says he worked private security for Wes Borland when he left Limp Bizkit.
Really?
What a weird time. Randy, I'm sorry. That seems like it was a very boring job after he left Limp Bizkit.
Yeah, who was the man?
Yeah, it was a horrible band called Blacklight Burns.
Oh, Blacklight Burns.
Oh, yeah, I had the T-shirts.
Yeah, but Dan is totally wrong. He kept painting himself.
He did.
Yeah.
When I met him, the first time I met him, he was wearing a sweater, like khakis and shit. And then right before he went on stage, he had total blackface. Like his whole body was painted black. He was wearing a Jason mask with a pantyhose over his head and a witch hat. I thought I actually lost him trying to get him up.
That's so funny.
How long did it take him to make himself up?
It
was like 2 hours.
Damn. He's like a 6-year-old that you let him do his own costume.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
I'm going to paint my face, put pantyhose and a witch hat. And you go, I don't know what any of that means.
Sick musician, though. He's a really good musician.
Yeah. Great guitarist.
Yeah, but one night he doesn't drink that much, and he was drinking Bombay and Sapphire, and some guy asked him what he was drinking. Nice. He said Bombay and Sapphire, and he called him a fucking faggot. He said, "You're a rock star."
Jesus.
So the guy called Wes Borland a faggot for drinking
Bombay and Sapphire.
What is Bombay, rum?
Bombay gin.
Gin. What's Sapphire?
I think it's called Bombay Sapphire, isn't it?
Sapphire is the type of gin.
Yeah, Sapphire is the type of gin.
What happened after you called him a faggot?
I hit him.
I was going to say. I'm like,
that's so funny.
He goes, oh, man, it was so funny. He goes, the guy just walked away and whatever. I go, weren't you a security?
He goes, yeah, but, you know, I mean, that was funny.
Can't throw a punch when you're buckled over with laughter. Goes,
I love Dan's answer. I hit him.
You just hit him.
Yeah.
Love it. Well, Wes Borland can't hit anybody because the evidence will be the paint on their face.
He's got his wet black knuckles.
Yeah. He goes, I can't hit him. I'm drying before the stage. I'm in my dry period.
Hey, Skankfest?
Yeah, thank you. I promoted that and produced it. What's going on with that?
Good job, Ari.
No, dude, at Skankfest, Jay, you got me higher than I ever had in my entire life. I was that big guy who told you used to be a merc.
Hell yeah, man. Fucking was it fun?
Yeah, no, it was a great time. But you got me, we were outside and you offered me a joint and fuck, that must have been some Ari shit.
Boom.
Slow me down.
Not this reputation. Month. Hey, how many stuff? Former bouncers do you think were at Skankfest?
Me, I'm one.
Yeah. That's right. Current.
At least 15. All the black guys were.
Yeah.
You could tell. Sure. Yeah, Skankfest is the one place where you're like, if I need someone to check IDs, let me just swing through here and pick up 5 recruits.
There were black guys at Skankfest. Did no one get my memos? Yeah.
There were black guys at Skankfest.
My best friend is a black guy.
That's true.
Is that Emily? Yeah.
You want to take another break?
It is. Are you hanging out for the rest of the show? Thank you so much for the call, Randy.
I think so.
All right, guys. Take it easy.
Absolutely. Dude, yeah.
And then, Ari's going to hang out. We're going to see the opening bands.
It's actually Christy's, like, Paul's favorite band.
Really?
Yeah, well, not favorite, but she likes him a lot.
I was going to say, if your girl's favorite band is the opening band for Florence and the Machine, then move on.
They put she puts pretty good bands on. She puts, I forgot who I saw. Who else does she have opening for?
When I saw her last time, I saw Grimes.
Was
2 years ago.
Yeah.
Oh.
On this tour, she has a lot of good ones.
Washington.
Yeah, that's tonight.
Oh, Kamasi Washington is tonight? Oh, well then fucking let's hit a commercial and see if we can get out of here early.
If you can tell from
what's his name? Kibasa.
Who's the chick?
Jay is currently at war with the blacks, if you can't tell from the beginning of the show.
Oh, Kamasi Washington.
Jay's at war with
black. Oh, yeah. Let's get there. I was hoping to hear world music tonight.
It is a dude in a dashiki just playing a fucking trumpet.
Are you guys bringing your own rain sticks, or are we going to just get them from merch?
Yeah, I think you can actually check them. We're going to take a break. We'll be right back hanging out with Ari Shaffir. It's the Bonfire. In many bedrooms, bedtime is... Jay? What's bedtime? Not even paying attention. It's complicated. Just like
sick
that.
Sick complicated,
bro.
Bedtime?
Especially
ridiculous.
As the weather begins to cool, one person sleeps so soundly, and then the other one freezing or way too hot. Bull & Branch, makers of the world's most comfortable sheets, loved by three U.S. presidents.
Three.
If you haven't heard that. Three.
It's a big deal.
They're offering their luxury flannel bedding for a limited time at bowlandbranch.com. Unbelievably soft, warm, and breathable. That's the key thing, the breathable. Because if you get all trapped and all muggy and gross, oh man, that breaks up cuddling.
Yucky.
Ew. Everyone stays the right temperature. That's the thing. And their stunning sheets come in, well, their flannel sheets come in 14 stunning patterns and colors.
Who stays the right temperature?
What's that?
Who stays the right temperature?
What, when they're sleeping?
The answer is everyone.
Sorry. Everyone. Everyone stays the right temperature. Oh, that one? Well, it's 30 nights risk-free, Ari. So it's something you can get behind.
I don't like risk. Is there any there?
There you go.
Zero like, risk.
Zero oh, that's risk. That's cool. And their flannel sheets sell out in just a few weeks. So go to bowlandbranch.com today for $50 off your first don't set wait. Of sheets. And free shipping with the promo code Bonfire. $50 off plus free shipping at bowlandbranch.com, spelled B-O-L-L and branch.com. Promo code Ari? What do you think the promo code is?
It's not Ari. I'm going to say Bonfire.
Yeah! I got up.
And now, back to the Bonfire with Big J. Okerson and Dan Soder.
I do know this song. I do know this song. I heard this in my over 40 ceramics class I take.
That's the fastest you've ever jumped in on a song when it's Christine's song. Like, when it's your songs, we play like all 3 minutes. He's like, wait till the third verse. And this one, you're like, guys, we're good. Let's go. Let's jump in.
Play it. Turn it up.
No, but I'm saying
this song's palatable for me.
I like A Kiss with a Fist. Do you should play that anymore? That was a fun one.
This is so. No, I was just bringing up a point.
Jeez, that you did.
Why are you trying to ruin your own song?
Yeah, now you can't. Now you're out. God, I'm fucking leaking over here.
Lou, please, some volume. You're talking over. I'm listening like a part? Fan.
To rock! To rock! So you love it.
To
Jay likes it, he just can't admit it.
I sang it.
I know the song very well. Sometimes I come home early and Christine's having women power hour alone. And she's singing this into a fucking hairbrush while she's not doing the dishes.
That's the most aggressive stance she can take against you.
It's that or fucking or I come in and it's just... oh man, that's the worst. When she has... I know she has control of Sonos and I'm taking a shit or something and the other room just start hearing fucking just Joni Mitchell songs. I know Christine just trying on robes and twirling in a circle because she knows that's when I try to shit fast so I can come out and catch her doing weird Wiccan stuff.
Yeah. She comes out. She's bloodletting from a chicken. She goes, hurrah! She goes, I'm trying to bring fall sooner. And Ari, are you unfamiliar with Florence and the Machine?
I know them a little bit.
Okay.
I know like, you know, some of their songs. But we saw them at Bonnaroo that time together.
Yeah.
Remember how boring that was?
Do you remember how when I had put my girlfriend up on my shoulders and you guys all looked at me like I was the sackless wonder?
Oh, yeah. You had fucking hot cooch neck. Yeah,
I mean, you were. That whole weekend you were. Oh, so it was prepped perfectly.
Yeah, oh, man. You had that damp cooch neck.
Yake. Did I remember the look over?
You don't want festival pussy on your neck. You do not want festival pussy on your neck.
You saying that?
Write that down, kids.
You saying that, though, just reminded me in my head of like when she was like, put someone up on your shoulders. And I looked over at my ex and I go, you don't want me to do that, do you? And she goes, I do. And I was like,
and then you just did it.
Yeah, I did it. It wasn't worth the fight, man. I've been fighting all weekend.
You did it twice.
No, just once.
If she's above me, she can't yell at me.
You didn't
yes,
do it again.
Exactly.
It turns out that wasn't true. She could yell down quite well.
And she could squeeze her thighs on my head. And I'm like, dude, brings it.
You're swaying wrong.
I remember you did that. And then who jokingly put...
Norman put Shafir on his shoulders.
On his shoulders. Yeah. And then Christine looked at me and I was like, I don't like this man.
And then all these years later, you're going to see him after...
You were having a good time with her.
With Florence and the Machine?
Yeah.
I didn't care for the music at all, no.
Oh, the music, yeah.
She was also, in her defense, it was daytime. She had a broken foot.
Yeah.
So there was all those things going
on. Barefoot on stones.
I swear to you, if it was like, I don't like this...
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I would, or there's no chance I'll like it. I really wouldn't go. Now, if Lou was like really wanted to go and I was the way he can go, I would bail out. But I'll go with him. Listen, I know If I'm bringing someone to see something they don't know, and I'm like, no, this is really the shit.
Yeah,
I want them to enjoy. So I wouldn't go.
That's my
like that,
that's my fear. Whenever I bring someone to a Queens of the Stone Age show, or like when we went and saw St. Paul and the Broken Bones at Terminal 5, I was kind of like, I hope you guys like this.
It's the worst. When you're like, listen, it's bad. Yeah. And you're like, it takes some time to get into something. Usually,
I've seen a lot of people to War on Drugs, but everyone seems to enjoy it.
I saw my old roommate Pete wasn't really into Queens of the Stone Age when really? I took him. We went to Lollapalooza.
That's why you're his old roommate now.
Yeah, and then I kicked that motherfucker out.
You got to make choices in this household, Mister.
You love Josh Homme or you sleep on the street. But it was kind of like a thing of like, not great. Not great. You know when you show someone a movie that you love and they don't love it the same and you're like, fuck.
Yeah.
Fuck.
I hate to say, a concert is generally as good. When someone wins you over totally, I think that's awesome.
When they're good performers.
This is going to make Ari give him plenty of ammunition here, but...
Little banjo band?
No. Kid Rock. I didn't give a shit about that album when it came out. And then I saw him live and just like, he plays every instrument. His performance, he gives a shit. He's a front man. So like, I was impressed by him in concert. But rarely do I go to a concert where I find the band at the concert. Where I go, oh, now I want to go hear all their shit. Marilyn Manson actually got me like that. The concert was insane. You know, I was like, I got to see what this guy like does. But for the most part, Mumford and Sons got me
Mumford
too.
Mumford and Sons is incredible live.
The people who that I go to see that I like know, I find are the best. That's why I say that the ones I talk about a bunch are like when we saw Billy Joel, or if we go to see Cypress Hill or whatever. When we went to see House of Pain and shit. Like, this is the ones where you, when you get there, you're like, oh shit. Arbitrarily, I just know every song I'm about to hear.
I think St. Paul and the Broken Bones won over Ari and
Greg. Yeah, I haven't heard of them at all. Maybe one song, maybe.
He performed his ass off.
Yeah.
When we went and saw him, he climbed the stacks. He was fucking jumping around in a leopard print suit.
If you just go for it.
Yeah.
Like bands that just go for it, we're like, doesn't even matter if I'm in the music.
Who was that
like
cupcake that Ari was trying to make us like at Panorama?
The pineapple guy.
Oh, what a handoff. Ugh. Glass Tiger.
Oh, yeah. That
Glass
was,
Animals. What are they called?
I'll tell you this. That was a big... That was the one where everyone looked around after a couple songs and we were like...
The guy looked like one of those shitty girl paintings from the 80s that were over something where they're always wearing like red lipstick and black sunglasses.
Yeah, what was their song?
Something pineapple.
It looks like none of them would be happy if we were at their house party.
They're awful.
If we were all at their party, they'd be like, can you guys just leave?
Yeah, that was a shit band.
They're good.
Not good.
Ari had some magical moment with a girl and some weird Canadian
I'm sure that's what it was. Yeah. Introduced to it the right way.
I know. You're the one. That's why you get into indie music a lot, because you live indie life.
Yeah.
Corduroys and a short sleeve button down shirt meeting a girl on a bus.
Ari goes, I was hiking.
An hour walk with her.
I was hiking through the Yukon and I met an Inuit girl that was into Glass Animals. Exactly.
I worked for her father's refinery for the next 3 months.
And then we were at Panorama and it's like, Ari, what is this?
They didn't get to dollop the whole venue like they used to.
No, they stink, man.
But Fair enough. I don't like them as much anymore after that.
Florence and the Machine, I just got into them on this album. She really is just like a amazing vocal talent. I've heard she's an amazing performer.
I liked Florence and the Machine's first album, and then when I saw her live, it actually did a disservice, because like I said, the fucking mysticism in the afternoon of like, we're all made of energy and everyone hold each other, and you're like, I'm looking at everybody.
I'm worried. Things like this build up Christine's like, I am woman, hear me roar shit. You know, it takes me weeks to break that back down to her thinking she's beneath me and needs to do my bidding.
I know. You tell me.
You know how many weeks that takes?
You're not a goddess.
You know how many weeks that takes after that? You are not a goddess.
You're telling me. Yeah, you always tell me you're giving Christine Cleveland basement time.
I
got to slide Christine's meal tray into the door.
Florence, tonight during the concert, she's like, if there's anyone out there in fingerless gloves holding you down, release yourself. Does anybody here need help? If you're a goddess, if you produce a radio show but get constantly barked at on it, you be yourself. And then Jason's looking at her going, don't you fucking think
you're better than that. I go, She's not talking about us.
She's not talking about us at all.
Can I tell you that I...
She said the gloves thing. He goes, fingerless gloves at a Florence the Machine concert. I mean, throw a dart.
I mean, take a risk. What are you talking about?
I told Eric...
Why don't you say a human being with a head will do this thing? I mean, come on.
Yeah, what'd you say, Ari?
I told Eric Abrams I was going to Florence the Machine with Soder and Jay. And he goes, Big Jay? And I was like, yeah. He goes, Big Jay Oakerson? He was like, yeah. He goes, he'll just look like a Hell's Angels who wanted to stop some hippie queers.
Is he kissing guys now?
Yeah. Big Jay. No, Big Jay Henderson.
I'm going to get four fights tonight because I'm going to start them because I'm going to look. That's gonna be a good numbers pad.
You're going
to start. The guy goes, dude, I fought four guys. And then he goes, yeah, but they were nervously asking you to please
stop booing.
Please stop picking on them.
Stop aggressively booing.
They asked me to stop booing. He goes, well, what they did was they got in my business. Well, Jay, what they did was they stopped you from strangling Christine.
Or you start cry fighting everyone. You're like, I don't like this man. And just jack a dude in the back.
Look at this jerk off from Glass Animals. I mean, what a knob off.
There's someone that loves Glass Animals that's listening to this right now that's like, fuck you, Jay.
I like the music.
I'm telling you, Ari saw himself in the lead singer.
He was actually, when I saw what he looked like, I was like, ooh, it was kind of like when you saw Nickelback for the first time. And you're like, I like this. Like, ooh, I don't like it anymore.
Totally. Yeah, you see someone that you only listen to, and you're like, fuck, I'm not into this anymore. Yeah.
That's why I went in, and when you played the Violent Femmes music in here, I was like, oh, yeah, let me go back. And I put on a video of Violent Femmes.
What do they look like? I don't remember.
Boy, oh, boy. It's hard to watch. It's hard to take that music, the vibe of that music that's got a pretty cool vibe to it, Violent Femmes.
Cannot watch it.
Man, they are just two dudes.
Which actually,
just two dorks.
Really?
Talking Heads is like the difference. Like, you see Talking Heads, and you're kind of like, I'm kind of fucking into this when you watch their live performance because you're like, yeah, this is kind of fun.
David Byrne's interesting, but I never liked their kind of thing, too. I don't get like suit rock. It was very bizarre. Unless I'm watching Billy Joel sit at a piano, and who gives a shit?
Yeah.
But if you're a front man of something, you can't be doing the suit, man. I don't care if you're the Killers or whatever. It's
David
weird.
Bowie, you're saying, could do it.
David Bowie did it, but I would prefer.
The Killers cannot.
They do.
What about the Animals? You ever see the Animals?
Way back. House of the Rising Sun?
They did it great.
No, but everyone did it back then. Alice Cooper's, Alice Cooper before they hit it big was...
Suit rock?
What were they called? Like the Veins or something like that? But they were, Alice Cooper was all suit rock.
Do House of the Rising Sun from the Animals.
Here they are. They rock and roll so hard he broke his boot stomping.
That's one of my favorite
Broke his
things.
Foot stomping.
I'm sorry, I have to burp.
Roll so hard he broke his heel stomping. This has got people crazy.
Oh, they're so cool. They're so fucking cool.
I mean, that's like cleaned up suit rock.
They're all walking forward.
I think we have to start putting our guests in where Jacob's sitting so they can see the show.
His lady friend is here. Is that what you're trying to say?
Yeah.
Did I nail it?
Why don't you just say it, you weirdo?
Yeah.
Instead of saying every fifth word.
Jerry O'Connell was in the Animals?
Show him the money.
Yeah.
Why do you say they did it the best? Or?
They were just so cool with the darkness of this type of music.
Yeah, but all of the moody blues were like frilly suits and shit, and they were like dark music too.
When you hear this, you expect it to be jeans and a t-shirt.
Yeah.
Yeah, and but none of it was.
Like,
but really none of it was.
Was Bruce Springsteen, like who was the first like shirt, t-shirt?
I mean, it all happened. I mean, all this music was coming out around the same time as, Doors were like, around this time too, and they just didn't do it that way.
Yeah, Rolling Stones.
The British influence was all the suits and shit.
Yeah.
Because they're all fashionable. And, poofdas.
Should we start wearing poofy shirts?
I'll dress like the Moody Blues now.
Should we start doing like comedy like that? Like if we took it back to like suit comedy?
I gotta tell you. The Moody Blues, the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, mind blow. How much that guy can still hit that song is difficult.
Yeah.
Knights in White Satin.
That song's what? Not good?
It's great.
Oh, yeah.
And the guy at whatever 80 years old he is kills it at the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame performance.
Yeah, those are like.
Kills it.
Those are like performers where they go back and they talk about how they came up. They're like, well, you played every night for 3 years. I didn't see my son until he was four. And you're like, that's all you did. It was all. That's all you did was music on the road.
On the road. Yeah, when we talk about going on the road, it's like 4 days in a row.
Yeah.
It's like, fuck off.
I felt like
I get that question every week and I feel bad answering because I always go, so what city are you rolling on to next? They go, well, I go home for 4 days and then I'm back.
Yeah.
They go, you're going to take, like, they're almost like, you're going to take the bus home and then go back on tour. You go, it's not really tour the way you think it's tour.
Yeah.
For comics, we other shit we have to do during the week.
Yeah. I did.
No one's coming to big comedy shows. Like, yeah, no one's coming to comedy clubs on like Monday or Tuesday for us, really. So yeah.
I did 3 cities in 3 nights, and I was like, I'm on the road. And then you're like, bands do this for 9 months at a time.
It does feel weird to do like rock clubs and you are gone like that. We're like, oh.
But that is when you have a home. Tour bus is huge for that.
Yeah.
That's great because it doesn't matter. If you did 3 cities, you'd have loved that more than staying put in one place for 3 days if you had a tour bus to go and hang out in.
Because it's like your hotel room.
Yeah, if I could just
your hotel room, and you wake up in your hotel room and you're in the next place.
That's great.
Fucking awesome.
And you're like, pull over, I'm going to freak out on acid.
Yeah. Can we do a tour bus comedy tour?
It's a good idea.
Like, dude, if like 3 or 4 of us got together.
Be fun.
Yeah, brilliant idea. Maybe I've been asking everyone about that for the past 5 years.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Maybe, I've maybe nonstop not. Been saying, it's the one thing I want to do is tour bus. I did the tour bus with those bands, but I was with the crew. Oh,
let's get Corn.
And
Corn! To
do it with us.
I was with the crew, though, and I was like, and I had a good time. I made friends on the bus and everything, but to start off that trek with friends, I was so jealous of the 2 Cents bus, the support act band.
Yeah.
That they were like buddies in a band, and that was their first bus tour ever they've done.
That's awesome.
And they had their own bus, and you can set up video games in the back lounge, and everybody, as long as someone's not a big dog and tries to like, you can get the back where the back is a bedroom, or you can get the backs where the back is a wraparound couch with a TV, and everyone just sleeps in the bunks, like sleep in the fucking bunk.
I'll do that.
And I've talked about it with 1,000 people, and then Dan has an epiphany, and we all start moving.
Dan, you're a thought man, you're an idea guy.
Thank you, Ari. Yeah. What I like to do is I like to visualize something and then address it and have it happen.
You're like a modern E.F. Hutton.
I hope you guys have fun on your bus tour.
Thank you so much. Yeah. I actually
Jake, can you shut up for a second? Jake, I'm trying to listen to ideas.
So anyways, I have this idea where I do a radio show with my friend. I just explained the bonfire. Just a radio show where we...
Just in the background, a kid playing catch by himself.
I go, Jay, fuck off. Hold on real quick. Ari, here's another idea. We do a whole album of crowd work. You go, that's your idea. Yeah, fresh from the dome.
Dan, I actually I ripped off a couple of those already.
Son of a bitch.
I'll shut up.
I really hope that there's a part of you that leaves Florence and the Machine tonight, like turn around. Like, no, fuck it.
There's nothing to turn me around on. Like, I'm almost opinionless right now. You don't have to turn me around. I just
You're not going in harsh?
No, not at all. No, listen.
No, Jake actually gives bands outside of his wheelhouse a legit chance.
I watched Black Keys with Ari. Thought it was great.
Okay.
Yeah. Great show. Mumford & Sons, fantastic.
I remember seeing you after that.
As much as everybody talked about My Morning Jacket, I wish I would have just checked them out at least to see what their thing is. I don't think I would like the music very much. But say Mumford & Sons.
Mumford & Sons.
I can't listen to their music, but that performance was fucking
It was almost like, at Bonner, it was almost like, actually, Jay, why don't you stay here? We're going to go check it out. And I'll come. I'll walk.
Legitimately.
Yeah.
We were like an hour late. We weren't even going to go, and it ended up being like a phenomenal performance.
Yeah. All I thought was I wish we would have seen the first half of it.
Yeah.
It was so good.
Remember we caught Natasha lying about it? She was like, it was Nick Thune. She was like, I've seen them. They weren't great. We're like, well, they just started. So I saw them before, and we're like, and I looked at Thune. He was like, wait, you're lying, right? He was like, she's for sure lying.
Yeah, that's funny. Dude, that's so great. You're like, yeah, I saw them yesterday. They sucked. They're playing in an hour. I saw Soundcheck.
Oh, they did Soundcheck. Because they did Soundcheck earlier today. He goes, was that earlier today? I thought it was yesterday.
Oh, that's crazy.
Yeah.
I don't
Today's
know.
Today's the 16th?
Okay. Day or night right now?
All right, gotcha.
Okay, I'm confused about that.
That was my bad. That was my bust.
You want to take our last break?
Let's take our last break. Yeah, we have commercials to read, Dan.
Irish Fear hanging out. I got a head cold.
It's the bonfire.
God damn right it is.
This is Glass Animals. I can already hear it.
Are you getting angry?
What's the song called? There's a song called Dork and Sea.
Oh, but you know what? I could see like liking this and then seeing this live and being like, fuck, this isn't what I thought it was.
Really?
They dress up the whole venue.
What, in stripy t-shirts like hipster dorks?
Yeah. It's the No Bread Band.
Hey, it's a t-shirt. It's got emojis on it.
Do you like wire rock? We're wiry.
Hashtag her too. It's the bonfire. We'll be right back. Groovy beat. I'd see this band live. Oh, it's just me. Hey, campers. Guess what? We just got hooked up with some awesome new security cameras from Blink Home Security. Blink are small, motion-activated video cams, and when they detect any movement, they send in an alert to your smartphone with a clip of what it just saw. Easy peasy, dude.
I got eyes on Trish. That's her security camera.
You know what's going on?
Blink's watching my mom's 6 and 12.
Hey, Mom, what was that whole thing with the plumber last week? I go, hey, you saw that?
The UPS guy comes a lot, and I sent you one package.
Baby, you're not supposed to watch the whole thing.
Looks like I still got my fastball. Looks like Mama can still throw heat, huh?
It syncs right up with your smartphone. It works right out of the box. And guess what? Blink is wire-free and runs on batteries that last for years.
You can't
there is no installation.
All the time, though. Not for your security system.
No, you don't have to.
Oh, great.
These batteries keep an eye on everything when you're out, everything in your home. There's no subscriptions, no contracts. And here's the deal we got for you, campers. You get three. That is three Blink cams for way less than the other guys charge. Plus, you get an extra 15% off if you visit blinkprotect.com/bonfire. Again, blinkprotect.com/bonfire. Blinkprotect.com/bonfire? You know it.
Yeah. I'm securing my answer.
And now, back to the bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Yeah, Dan, good idea. Let's take an edible and get in this deep, dark shit.
Hell yeah.
You want to take an edible, man? Just really space out?
I'll see you. I'll see you on the other side.
My dad didn't call my daughter for her birth yesterday.
I'm going to come out.
That's weighing on me pretty good.
Yeah, just let it just fall back into the voice of Florence.
This ginger's going to climb to my soul.
She's been around for a while now. Do you think there'll be some older people there with their kids?
Yeah, the lead singer, Florence.
I would say she got big in like 2011, 2010, 2011. It's been around 7 years.
Yeah. $300 bet right now she has a shamrock tattoo on her body somewhere.
Yeah, she used to drink a lot, so probably.
That's easy money, dude. Oh, man. Imagine how purple her teeth get when she gets wine drunk.
Oh, boy, yeah. All right, $2,000 bet right now. You can see blue veins in her tits.
I bet you're right.
Yeah.
You guys are no fun to bet with.
Well, you're just saying things.
You guys know everything.
I love when Christine just
gets
wine
real,
drunk.
She's got a real...
blue red all over you. Like, I need to go talk to the owners of this stand and tell them what they're doing. I'm just trying to tell them I'm not drunk. Probably don't tell them anything.
I quit, Ari.
So my favorite one was always that. He goes, I don't know if you need to have that one. You're pretty hammered. She's like, fine, I fucking won't. I fucking won't. I'm sorry. Well, I didn't know I was making such a problem. I didn't know I was even drunk, but that's fine. If you say stop, I'll stop, I guess. He goes, your eye is falling out of your head. Is it?
Or am I looking at you in a new light?
Or am I checking for danger around this? I'm sorry, Carol.
No, you have pug eye.
Yeah. I'm telescoping. Telescope up.
That's how you can tell Christine. Oh, she went wonk eye.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
One lazy.
One eye just went goof.
Nate said that my drunk tell was I started slurring slightly, but very, very
that's
slightly.
Everybody's
that's
everybody's drunk.
That's Jay's. Jay will slur, and he doesn't know he's slurring. It's
I do
adorable.
Know it. I call it out.
Nate's tell is he stops looking around before he gets racist.
Oh, yeah. Nate starts putting some oomph behind it.
Yeah.
He goes, I'll say it.
He goes back to all those plus signs he graffitied and finishes the swastikas.
This ain't about positivity.
He just adds those four extra lines.
We're all thinking. I'll say it. Like, Nate, none of us are thinking it. None of us are thinking it.
He's like, you know what? I'll be the one to tell him. Y'all wait here. No, we're going to go. We're going to go make sure you're all
right. Yeah, slurring, I would just be like, what do you fucking mean? Fuck, I feel so good.
Ari, you just turn on everybody. I love it. Boston's going all the way. You suck. Ryan O'Neill, you suck.
16-1.
You know what?
Ryan O'Neill got so mad at me for that.
Did he really?
Still, right?
And I was like, I'm not apologizing, you punk.
Train harder.
You won 40 seconds of that fight.
Did he win 40 seconds, though?
Yeah, maybe the first 40.
Well, yeah, kept
I'll tell you this, if I was Ryan, though, I'd be pretty fucking mad if you tweeted that.
My
I'd be like,
God.
Come on, dude, you're my only guy in this fucking
bed. I went the distance in an MMA fight.
I was exhausted. Yeah, you didn't do much.
I like that's the answer. I guess you did.
Yeah. And he goes, fuck, that was so hard.
Did you go the distance? Like, you lasted the distance.
I mean,
you weren't going for all of it.
Saw it through. You can raise a kid till it's 18. It doesn't mean you're a good parent.
I'm so the opposite of that. I'd be like, dude, that was your balls out for even going into it, man.
That's what I love about Ari.
Yeah. You showed weakness.
Mitzi always told me never to encourage mediocre talent.
I'd be like, dude, you should treat yourself with a dessert tonight. Ari's like, die. You should have died in the ring. A warrior dies in the ring if he loses.
That's really hilarious that Paulie Shore's mother says, I don't accept mediocre talent. I will not accept mediocre talent.
Never now, encouraged.
If you guys would like to watch Jury Duty, we're having a screening.
She never encouraged him.
She never encouraged Paulie. That happened without her encouragement.
Is that true? Yeah. That might be true.
Yeah.
Really?
She was never like, you're the best.
You do you think a lot of that was looking for mommy's love? Like he wanted to succeed in the field, that like do better without her help?
Yeah, well, he never got it. She died without ever loving him. So
no, is that true, you think?
I think on her deathbed she was like, had a moment of clarity. She would come out of it once in a while.
She goes, somebody get me the weasel.
Where's the weasel? Boop. I need to speak to the weas.
Hey, Madre.
Paulie, I need to tell you, you're garbage.
But you said she had moments of clarity?
Yeah, later.
Yeah.
Andy Dick's also my child.
She clearly said she didn't love her son.
She goes, Jury Duty wasn't bad.
Aw, it sure wasn't good. Making me feel this way.
You want me to get the doctor?
Uh-oh, she's having a seizure. Mama San's having a little bit of a seizure.
She's having a coronary. She's dude, getting.
There's got to be nothing.
Her
more.
Eyes are starting to get hematomas.
Oh, Massey getting glassy. Dude, there's got to be nothing.
He used to love Fred Durst.
Really?
They were buds.
Oh, dude.
So yeah. Does that mean, in turn, he is now an enemy of Shaggy 2 Dope?
I believe he would be.
Oh, all right. Yeah, you draw out the battle lines, dude.
Fucking
the
war of rat metal wars.
Bat Biscuit versus the clowns.
What was he doing on stage with him, though? Like,
they were at a festival together.
They were at a festival. Oh, okay. He came out and tried to dropkick
him. And he said that.
For some shit in the 90s.
Yeah, Fred Durst disrespected him, invited him on Family Values tour.
28 years ago?
Yeah.
20 years ago.
Yeah.
19 years ago.
He's holding on to it.
Why didn't he just shove him into the audience?
Hey, Louise and Fred Durst.
Hey, Mom, look who I brought to cheer you up.
She goes,
no.
Doing an improv game.
She goes, now there's talent.
She goes, Paulie, look out of the way.
Move to your
Mr.
left.
Mr. Durst.
I respect everything you do.
Can I say to you, your lyrics?
Interesting 360, things. The old talent coordinator, Tommy, worked at the club that those guys, Limp Bizkit, started in Jacksonville.
Really? Oh, really?
I know they had talent, okay? I could tell.
Did he tell Fred Durst a long story about Desi Arnaz before he passed him like he did with me?
Come back a few times.
I want to see if you're right with the room, Fred Durst.
If that's what you want. Oh, fool away with people on the way in the back. For the people on the side.
Can I get a couple tickets for my mother?
I like a starfish hot dog flavored water.
Oh, dude.
I'm going to go backstage.
Yeah, that's got to be fucking incredibly shitty to be in the field where your mom owns one of the most legendary comedy club.
He's only in the field because his mom owned the legendary comedy club.
Yeah. And still going to get, well, so he's doing it like despite her, but he's getting all the stuff because of his accessibility to the business.
What a solutionless problem. You know what I mean?
It is solutionless.
Whatever happens.
Right. And no matter what, failure or success, and he has some success.
I mean, all of us got into it.
But failure or success, he's going to get family fucking money.
He did a bunch of movies.
No, I'm saying he's
crazy.
I'm saying he had a lot of success. Yeah. I'm saying, but if that didn't happen,
yeah, right. He'll still
be
an inheritor.
Yeah, he's going to inherit a ton of money.
Yeah, it's.
It's an assumption.
But I'm saying, what a kind of hellacious position to be in, where you're like doing it for a thing you'll never get.
Right.
I mean, imagine
being one of the new rocks.
Yeah,
but it's also like
Mark Seinfeld.
But forever, like, he is the weasel, though. Like, he's got to be, like, he made a character that was very timely and connected to people and that thing.
Blew up in the 90s.
And now
it was a crossover.
And now
hit.
It's like a thing, though. But now it's like, how can you go watch him not be the weasel in something? It's impossible.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, he would have to do like.
I like son-in-law. Remember when I'll always stand by son-in-law.
I like that breakdown moment the celebrities have. It's like, yeah, it's all just. No one love. Me.
Yeah. No, I love me.
Did he have that?
No, but he still has to be the weasel as he's
oh,
doing
no
it.
Matter what. Yeah.
Hello. I guess my whole life I've just been searching for like love.
I got canceled in Wisconsin because I couldn't sell any tickets.
tickets.
Yeah. It is.
He does sell tickets, though.
Yeah.
Pauly Shore, I think, right? Does he do good, Ari?
He does well where the PBA is. Professional Bowling Association.
Why is that? What's the correlation?
They play cities outside major markets. They don't play Vegas. They play Reno.
Oh, gotcha.
Things like that.
I see it.
Second oh, you're right, because he was coming to, was that Greenville, South Carolina club I did. He was like, him and Bob Saget. Is that the
Pittsburgh
move?
Guy than a Philly
is
guy?
Is that the move? Is that you, not Bob Saget, it was like Dave Coulier or something, but if you're famous on that
kind Jerry Gladstone?
Yeah. If you're famous on that kind of level,
yeah.
Going to B markets probably is a murder, because they can't believe, even 30 years later,
yeah.
That they're seeing you. Dude, that you came to their fucking town, you're across from their Jamba Juice or whatever.
The only time I work Sanford and Sons in Kansas City.
Stanford and Sons.
Well, I call it Sanford and Sons because I like the show.
You're racist.
I like Red Fox. And it made me feel better. When I worked Stanford and Sons, the only time I worked it, the guy picked me up from the airport and he was like new. And he's like, yeah, dude, it's fucking awesome. And I was like, oh, I didn't really know what kind of club it was. I knew it was like, you know, an okay comedy club in Kansas City. But I was like, so who's like, you know, are you like working at the comedy clubs? Dude, it's fucking awesome. Screech was he was here last week. And you're like, oh, fuck.
Screech also coming to Greenville, South Carolina. Yeah.
And then awesome. He goes, and before that, Michael Winslow. And I was like, dude, there's no way you even know about Police Academy. The kid was like 20. This was like 7 years ago.
He had been told about Winslow? It when he was there. And then yeah. He's like, yeah,
oh,
right.
That's exactly what big. It was. He was like, oh, yeah. It was a big movie in the 80s. It's like, you didn't see him.
It is funny to be at a comedy club, though, and going by the wall of like the posters going mm-hmm. up, and it's like, this week, you know, me. And then you see it's like Michael Winslow, Screech, something. You're like,
dude, you want to know one of the best
you're
ones?
Like, am I the exception, or am I just one of these? And exactly. Actually, the thing is, like, they're all actually far, far more successful overall than I am.
But you think you're like, is this where I'm at? When I was in Tucson, one of the headshots at Laughs was a guy from Budweiser beer commercials. And he was like a beer guy in the 80s, like a commercial actor. Whoa. You know what I mean? Like mm-hmm. one of those comics that was like, he had a catchphrase. It was one of those things they always warn about. And it's his headshot, and he's like, this bud's up yours. You know? And he's like, he's here in a week. And you're like, what? Oh, fuck.
Still trying to lay off that catchphrase.
Yeah. Or a headshot of a guy pulling his hair. Like, yeah. Hey, it's going crazy.
Yeah. But that
those,
is.
But those clubs, I never trust a club. I've had great ones, but when I go on the website to get the information to promote,
yeah,
and it's like Big Jokerson special event, no free passes, and you're like, all right, well then who's coming next week? Because holy shit, like, I'm the special event. Shut down the town, everybody.
Shut it.
Friday
down.
Night lights. Big J wheeled into Greenville, South Carolina.
We got a parade for you.
Stop the fair.
From the freeway, it's Big J.
They bring a band in.
I heard he's been to an airport.
They greet you off the plane like a president of a small nation. Oh, look at him.
Like Weird Al and Naked Gun. Weird Al on the plane.
It's, yeah, that's one of the ones, the special engagements. It always hurts when you have like a light, empty late show and they send waitresses home and then they're like, it's all right. Piff the Dragon's coming on Wednesday.
Oh, like, yeah.
When an America's Got Talent magician is like their makeup
he
sale.
It.
Yeah.
I'm going to Edmonton, and I think the week after me is the Tourette's guy from America's Got Talent.
It is.
Although particularly the Bronsons, like they jump on the reality star ones.
Yeah, I love it.
They jump big on that because Piff was there way early. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, he's all over it.
They jump, but I mean, it's not a bad business model. People do it. You have at least a year. I think Piff still sells tickets.
Piff, yeah.
But he also does magic and the thing. But as far as just the stand-up kid, I don't know what.
But there's like
that other kid was like funny, and I don't know what happened. They make Taylor Williamson. I don't know what it does for him on the road if it's still killing for him.
It's supposed to just get you in, and you got to go from there. But like Piff had this thing where he had like. Goldfish they would like swallow and spit back up and stuff mm-hmm. and he would in his rider he'd be like you have to dispose of these humanely, like free them into some sort of natural environment. And I was like, oh, that's cool. And I talked to like multiple waitresses at different clubs, like we flush them.
Yeah.
He's gone, there's no rider anymore.
Yeah. Do you think like the second you're not done at the club they're not like, we have to respect all of Mr. Dragon's wishes?
I like when you go into the green room, he's like, he's got a matchbook with the fish on it with like he's getting a Viking funeral ready. He's pouring like gasoline on them.
He's got a tiny arrow that he's gonna shoot a fire.
He takes one match of the book,
he goes, he's sitting there in his dragon suit, he was a good fish, a fair fish, a war fish. Yeah, that's it's I understand like hiring the YouTube kids to do like Tuesday, Wednesday shows so your staff makes money so guys like me can do comedy Thursday through Saturday. Mm-hmm. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
But it just does hurt when you're like, when they're like, ah, it's all right, we'll make it up with Piff next week.
Oh,
like,
seeing a girl you recognize her. Where I recognize this girl from? She was in a waitress uniform not 20 minutes ago.
Yeah.
And now she's wearing jeans. Got it. That is why. That is a disconnect. Okay, you're leaving? Taking off? Great.
Cool. Thought we were friends from middle school.
You know, it only took one time of a server who got cut from my show for them to say, I don't know if it was even guy or girl, but whoever it was, just being like, yeah, I got cut, but I changed, but I'm going to like hang out and watch the show now. I actually want to watch the show. It only took one time, and now when everyone's leaving, yeah. I go, ah, they cut you. There's not enough, no one in the balconies or whatever like that. And they go, yeah, they let me go home. And you're like, you can still stay and watch the show, but all right, I guess go home.
You're
then.
Saying that fucked all it right. up now.
Yeah, because now I'm like, now you're just gonna leave. I mean, you could have just stayed and watched the show.
Yeah, they did that with me, and I was like, yeah, I'm gonna stay and watch the show in Austin. I was like, oh, it's cool. You got $20.
You go. I just gotta let you know that it is a 2-drink minimum, so you're gonna have to get two things on the menu.
Early prediction for the night: Dan and Christine go back to drinking. Hardcore.
You think hard.
They have a domestic fight. I have to break it up.
Get ready.
Christine throws a shaggy 2-dope drop kick.
She misses. I come around. I hockey her with her her blouse scarf. Wham, 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 wham.
Well, what if I fucking shaggy 2-dope Florence?
Give when you fucking... build a ship to last.
Oh, a giant man kicked me.
He kicked me in the back. He did. He does.
You want to bet if she does performs barefoot or not?
She definitely will. Isn't that her whole stupid, wicked thing?
I don't know.
Is she going to wear something flowy probably also? You guys going to take any more bets?
Christine's getting angry.
I hope. Will she be blotchy from today's sunlight? Anything else anybody want to throw in there? All right, let's go flow hard, guys.
Are you ready to flow?
Flow on, flower.
Are you ready to get your flow on? AriShafir.com for tour dates.
Yeah, special on Netflix right now.
Go check it out, Double Negative.
Double Neg.
Check it out on Netflix. You can also put it in your calendar, October 30th for Big J. His Netflix special is coming out as part of The Degenerates. Also, Edmonton, Canada, October 18th through the 20th. Big J is going to be at Comic Strip, maybe following a little Piff
That's
Dragon.
Very right. And
Ari and Jay going to be together in Phoenix, Arizona at the All Things Comedy Festival, October 26th and the 27th. For tickets, go to BigJComedy.com or AriShafir.com, you know, if you want to do it.
Absolutely. Dan Soder going to be at DC Draft House in Washington, D.C. this weekend, Thursday through Saturday. Then at Magoobies in Maryland, Sunday, October 14th. That is this Sunday coming up. After that, he's going to be in San Diego, American Comedy Company, October 19th and 20th. That's only Friday and Saturday. For tickets and all their tour dates, visit dansoder.com. Don't forget to check out the Best of the Bonfire, our Friday show they air here.
Get it.
The Best of the Day Bonfire.
Did you not have it?
Available now as a podcast. Wherever you get podcasts from, you can download it. Download, subscribe, rate, review. Let us know that you're listening so we can have some track on what's going on. And also our videos.
Yeah, go check them out on YouTube.
Our weekly videos that go out now every week on Comedy Central's YouTube channel.
Yeah, check them out.
Super fun. Hopefully we have some fun future plans for those. So let's...
And let's see tomorrow if Bev was just being nice or if Jay was right.
Yeah, we'll see tomorrow, everyone.
Or we won't have a show.
Or we're fired already. Let's hope not. Everybody, we love y'all. Crackle, 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 crackle.